Hi everyone, I'm Andreas Westphal. I'm extension hematologist at the Kearney Agricultural Research Center, and I'm going to show you some procedures how to sample soil and roots for nematode detection. Numbers developed from that can then be used for your management decisions either in walnuts or also in almonds.
Nematodes are small aquatic roundworms. Many are beneficial because they help to recycle nutrients in the soil by feeding mostly on microorganisms. In contrast, plant parasitic nematodes feed only on live host plant roots. Plant parasitic nematodes consume plant resources, distort or otherwise damage root tissue, interfere with water and nutrient uptake, and may predispose the tree to other pathogens. Therefore, heavily infested trees are often stunted and lack vigor. There are three types of nematodes of particular concern to commercial walnut and almond growers. Root knot nematodes live in a portion of the life cycle in the soil and then migrate into the root and core scalds near their feeding site. Lesion nematodes can feed inside the root, causing back lesions, but can also live in the soil and feed from the outside on the roots. Ring nematodes live in the soil and feed on root tips. Though often found in walnut soils, their effect on tree health is only poorly understood. Lesion nematodes are generally the most problematic for California walnuts and are found in most walnut orchards in California. Severity of damage from each species depends on the rootstock susceptibility, tree age, soil type, and nematode numbers. Before planting or replanting an orchard, take soil samples to inform rootstock selection and other management practices. Soil samples for nematodes are best taken prior to the removal of the previous orchard or crop. At that time, you can more easily find the previous tree's feeder roots, which host the nematodes. There's also more moisture and therefore live nematodes near the soil surface before fallowing. If you're sampling bare ground before planting, the less visible the old tree rows are, the more samples need to be taken to make sure to not miss an infestation. The longer the field has been fallowed, the deeper the soil needs to be sampled. Try to sample shortly after orchard removal. Sampling can be done at any time of the year. However, it is preferred from September through February, when the soil is moist and nematode numbers are highest. To sample for nematodes, first divide your orchard into sampling blocks that have similar soil texture and drainage patterns, cropping history, and crop symptoms. Nematode damage can be confused with damage caused by other pathogens, or in pests or abiotic factors. Therefore, compare sampling blocks of healthy trees with those that show symptoms to refine management decisions in established orchards. Sampling blocks should be between 5 acres for a smaller orchard or 20 acres for larger ones. The soil sample for each sampling block will be a composite comprised of several randomly collected subsamples that are taken near several trees in the block. To get your first subsample of soil in an existing orchard, choose an area in the zone of new root growth of the tree, where there is soil moisture. Typical guide is the drip line of the canopy, which is where the water hits the ground dripping off the outermost branches. At the intersection of this line and the wetted area of the irrigation is the most appropriate area to sample. This is where nematode populations are expected to be highest. Use a shovel, auger, or a soil probe. Push the probe into the soil so the entire tube is in the soil. Then twist and pull the probe out of the ground. Scrape the soil into a bucket using a screwdriver or similar tool if needed to dislodge the soil. In existing orchards, make sure to include some roots in the subsample so that lesion and other root-dwelling nematodes can be detected. Collect at least 5 to 7 subsamples per sampling block, making sure you have at least a quart of soil and root fragments for each composite sample. Mix the soil from these subsamples thoroughly in a bucket and place this composite sample in a sealed 1-quart plastic bag. Attach a label to each bag with your name, address, and location of the orchard, sampling block number, soil type, and depth. Also add cropping history and notable symptoms. If replanting, list the rootstock and cultivar of both the previous crop in the sampling block and the one you intend to replant. Ensure the bags are sealed tightly to prevent the content from drying out. Use a cooler or natural shade to keep the samples away from direct sunlight and cool as quickly as feasible until they are sent to the lab. Refrigerate, but do not freeze the samples. Freezing kills the nematodes, and many nematode extraction procedures require the nematodes to be alive, or at least physically intact. Send the samples to the lab in an insulated container as soon as possible after sampling. Avoid sending samples on a Friday when the samples will sit over the weekend before delivery to the lab. Contact your local cooperative extension advisor for more information on site-specific sampling strategies, including information on local diagnostics labs. For more information on nematode monitoring and management, see the walnut or almond pest management guidelines at the University of California Statewide Integrated Pest Management Program website.